Hi, it's Vicky here and welcome to the second day of my week featuring Avrielle. Today I will be making a birthday card using this stamp set. The stamp set also has matching dies and it is called Bring On The Cake. So for today's card I will be using the big cake that comes in this stamp set and I am going to stamp it on a white cardstock by using my black Memento ink. I'm using black Memento ink just because I will be using my Copic markers to color a part of this image. Actually, the cake is going to be a paper pieced image, and you'll see what I mean as I move on. But first, I am going to color the main part of the cake. I like chocolate, so I just had to color my cake brown. I am using only two colors of brown. And I don't care if I go outside the lines, since I will be using my scissors to cut out this part of the cake. So I'm adding my darker shade where I feel that it needs some shading. And now I'll go ahead and cut out the main part of the cake using my scissors. When you use your scissors to cut out a piece, it doesn't have to be totally perfect. You can fix things at the end by using a black marker and going all around the edges to get rid of the white edge. In this case, I'm not using a black marker as I would normally, but I'm using the brown marker that I've used to color the cake, so it matches perfectly. This is microfine glitter and I will be using that to work on the frosting of my cake. So first of all, I am going to cut a piece of double-sided tape. You will find a link to all the supplies that I'm using just below the video or on my blog. So I'm making sure that this is stuck down nicely. And now I am going to apply my microfine glitter. The glitter that I'm using is opaque white and it kind of sticks to the paper very nicely just because it's micro and it kind of becomes the same as the paper. It will not move or go anywhere like any other glitter. So a great tip when you use this microfine glitter is to rub it with your bone folder, and not only it helps the glitter to stick down nicely, but it also makes it shine. The more you rub it, the more it shines. And as I'm doing that, just to remind you that there is a giveaway running on my blog. So if you want a chance to win an adorable stamp set by Avrielle, make sure to join my blog and enter your details. So now that I'm happy with my frosting, I am going to use my scissors and cut around it. I am going to cut only the frosting and I hope you can see how nice and shiny it looks. It's kind of velvet shiny. I don't know how to explain that. But now I am going to stamp a little strawberry that comes in the stamp set. And there is actually a matching die for this. To color the strawberry, I am not going to do any shading at all. After all, I plan to add glossy accent all over it, so it won't really show. And it's such a tiny little image. Finally, I am going to stamp the cake once more, and this time I am going to stamp with Versa marking because I plan to do some embossing. I am going to be using the Platinum Embossing Powder by Ranger, and this is a nice silver embossing powder, and that's because I want to have my cake plate in silver. And as you can see, I don't bother of embossing the whole cake image. I only focus on the dish. And that's because I am going to stick all the other parts one on top of the other. So once this is set up, I am going to use my die cutting machine and the matching dies to cut out the cake and the strawberry. And then I will go ahead and assemble my cake. I want to put the strawberry so that it nicely nests at the center of the frosting, and that's why I'm using my craft knife. I am going to go and cut out a smaller slit where that black line is. A great tip when you are using your craft knife is to apply no pressure. Sometimes when you apply a lot of pressure, you get harsh lines instead of nice and smooth lines with a craft knife. And it's better to go slowly and very softly and go over and over again that line that you are making instead of trying to push too hard. I hope that makes sense. So now I am assembling my cake. I am placing one part of the cake over the other, and that actually creates a little bit of dimension. You can't really tell at the video. All the layers of the cake are made out of heavy cardstock, so when you see the card at first hand, you can really tell the dimension. For my sentiment, I am going to combine three different sentiments that come in the same stamp set. So I will actually create the Make-A-Wish has no calories. I think that's really funny. And I am going to stamp the word wish, which I am going to emboss it with the red embossing powder by Ranger. And then I am going to stamp Make-A and the other phrase that says has no calories, and emboss it with the silver embossing powder, the platinum one, that I've used for the dish of the cake. I am going to use foam squares at the back of the cake to add a bit of dimension, and I am going to stick it at the bottom corner of my panel. Today I'm making a standard card that's 4.25 by 5.5, and I am going to create the card out of white cardstock. However, I need some pattern paper for the background. This is an Averiel paper pad, and it's the Bride's collection, and I really love the designs because they are very generic. They are chevrons, little hearts, stripes, and very vibrant colors. So if you are on the looks for a nice pattern paper, I think that's it. I'm going to stick this die at the center of the chevron, and I'm going to die cut it with my C6 machine. And now my panel is slightly smaller than my card base. I am using my tape adhesive at the back. This is my 80G gun. And I am going to stick it at the center of my card base. So I have a nice white border all around. Now I am going to stick my focal point at the center of the card by using some foam tape at the back. And this will add just a little bit of dimension. To finish off my card, I have created two more strawberries from the same stamp set using the dies and the same Copic markers, which I have stacked one on top of the other, and with a little foam tape at the back, I am going to stick it on top of my sentiment. So this is going to combine everything together, and as always, I am going to use my Wink of Stella over the strawberries. I did that also on the strawberry that's on the cake. And I am going to cover up the strawberries with glossy accents. And that's what I did with the strawberry on the cake as well. And this will finish off the card for today. I hope you had fun and got inspired. And if you did, don't forget to leave me a comment as well as give me thumbs up on my YouTube channel. Here are a couple of close-up photos of the card today. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel already, make sure to do so, since it's the way to tell me that you love my videos and you want to see more. Thank you all for watching.